Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Ash Tulloch, and welcome to Olympic Winter Games Daily. We are coming to you from Beijing 2022 with the one, the only Super Jules, aka Olympic gold, two-time silver and bronze medalist, Julia Mancuso. Julia, so nice to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you.
I love the fact that you're coming to us from Fiji, and here I am in wintry, cold, freezing Beijing. What's it like for you being somewhere hot when we have the Olympic Games right here in China?
Well, it's great that the time difference for me in Fiji isn't too bad, so I'll get to watch a lot of the action live. But yeah, it's weird being in the warm when there's Olympics going on in the cold, but it's also nice to spend a little quality time with my family.
A couple of very quick fire questions. You said that, you like speed, but let's see how quick you can be with these. All right. Most famous contact in your phone.
Gosh, I don't know. That's a funny one. Owen Wilson and, he's a friend of mine. That's probably the most famous. Not an athlete, but.
Which athletes party the hardest?
Okay, this is a good one. I think the athletes party the hardest that work the hardest and never get to party. So when we would go to visit the, we all got invited to the president and go to the White House, and it was always the speed skaters and the cross country skiers. It was always the endurance athletes that just let loose because they never get to party. So I think they partied the hardest.
I love that. Which sport is cooler, snowboarding or skiing?
Definitely snowboarding. I joke all the time. My good friend's Jamie Anderson, and I'm always writing her like, I wish I was as cool as you. I want to come back in another life and be really cool like you.
I love that you're still close friends with these incredible athletes that are competing here. And last one, raising two boys or winning Olympic gold, which is hardest?
Raising two boys so far, for sure. They have so much energy and nothing is ever for myself anymore, but it's great.
Hey, let's put your winter beanie on. Thinking about Beijing 2022, what are you most excited about?
Well, I am really looking forward to the competitions, especially the alpine skiing, obviously. But I think what I've seen so far is the terrain is incredible and it's, mostly man-made snow. So I think we're going to see a lot of really high-level competition and a lot of surprises. So I'm looking forward to that.
Surprises. Who are you expecting surprises from?
Well, that wouldn't be a surprise then, would it? But I think that it's going to be hard for those favorites to win. Of course, I'm always rooting for my fellow Americans. And so, Michaela Schifrin, and then on the men's side, having Bryce Bennett and Travis having some great results this year. I'm really excited to see them. I think that might be a really good gliding course too, but yeah, I don't know. I feel like when you go to a new venue and when you're in conditions that are a little different than normal and everyone had to travel pretty far to get there, you just never know what's going to happen. There could be definite surprises.
You mentioned Michaela Schifrin before. She's in five alpine skiing events. What do you make of that?
Well, it's always hard. I think I tried to compete in five in Torino, and I remember dropping the slalom because I wanted to focus on the GS, and the other events didn't go exactly as I wanted to have them go. But I think that it's also fun and exciting, and I wouldn't be surprised, though, if she ends up dropping an event.
Yeah, it's interesting you say that because we sort of saw part of that in Pyeongchang. There was so much pressure on her to succeed. Do you think there is that same level of pressure on Michaela this time around in Beijing?
Oh, gosh. I think that in a lot of ways, yes. But in a lot of ways, I feel like she has a new perspective, and just with the passing of her father and getting back into competition, she's not really going into this with a track record of winning everything. I almost feel like it's better because she has this, ability to now prove to everyone that those past World Cup races where she wasn't winning this season, she can do it on the Olympic field. So I don't know. I think it can go both ways. Sometimes it's harder when you're at the top. So right now, not that she's an underdog, but she definitely hasn't been winning everything. So that's almost an advantage for her.
This is going to be the most gender balanced Winter Olympic Games in history, but I'd be intrigued to know what you think about female coaching and whether that's something that is being developed or if we're making progress in that area.
We're definitely making progress in ski racing. There is a female coach on our speed team, but it is rare. It's much more rare to have a female coach in ski racing. And so hopefully that continues to evolve and there's more females getting out there. But yeah, I don't know. It's tough. It's tough physically. Not that females can't do it, but I was talking about this the other day, especially technicians. So for those that don't know much about ski racing, we have technicians that take care of our skis and make them perfect. And most athletes will have their own, like at the very top high level. And then some will have, you know, three athletes per ski tech, but they're taking care of all the skis. We travel with hundreds of skis. Like, it's actually quite ridiculous. But yeah, we were talking that there aren't very many females in that space either. And I don't know why. It's growing, it's evolving, and there's been a few in my day, and I love to see it grow more. A lot of my athlete friends, and I would call them family from when we were on the team together, are now coaching their respective home teams. So there's a lot more going on at a junior level. And yeah, I'm sure we'll see it happening more and more at a senior level, and hopefully in the Olympics to come, more female coaches, especially for the female teams.
And, you know, you've got to hope and think that being able to watch and witness these incredible athletes from all around the world competing are going to inspire little girls to believe and hope that they can one day be a Julia Mancuso or a Lindsey Vonn or a Michaela Schifrin or be a technician.
Yes, or a technician or a coach. There's so much opportunity.
Well, I hope that you pull out that iconic Wonder Woman suit and let those boys know who is boss, because around the world we've had so many wonderful years of you as a fantastic skier, and now we get to witness you being a great mum, and it's so great to be able to tap into your knowledge as we enjoy Beijing 2022. Julia Mancuso, so nice to catch up with you.
Thanks. Have a good one, and good luck to all the athletes. I'm excited to watch.
Thanks, Julia. Enjoy the games.
Thanks.
Nordic combined event, normal hill, 10 kilometer, individual Gunderson. Eric Frenzel, defending Olympic champion. 106.5, so he's a little bit short. At the age of 29 years and 85 days, fabulous Eric Frenzel wins the gold medal.
And for you guys at home, thanks so much for watching. We will be back again tomorrow for more fun from Beijing 2022 for the Olympic Winter Games Daily right here.